Today's story is called The Family Pet, about two parents who are looking for a pet and what kind of animal would fit well with their family and their two children.
家庭宠物，约翰和莎拉有两个孩子，儿子五岁了，女儿七岁了。约翰和莎拉知道他们的孩子已经长大了，可以承担起一些责任了。他们一直想要一只宠物，于是准备买一只。他们不知道什么样的宠物最适合他们的生活方式。喂养金鱼的话，体验感不够强。萨拉又怕鸟，所以他们不会养鹦鹉。
All right, let's look at a few of the more difficult words in this story. Start out, 宠物, pet. 长大, to grow up. And let's look at the parts of this word. If we scroll down here. So, 长大, and then 长, there we go. That's the version we're looking for, to grow. And then 大, big. So, to grow big. 责任, responsibility. 什么样, what kind? And if you've learned a little bit of Mandarin before, you probably recognize the 什么, the what, and 样 is kind or type of something. 方式, manner or way. 喂养, to feed or to raise an animal. 金鱼, goldfish. 体验, experience. 鸟, bird. And 鹦鹉, a parrot. All right, now that we've gone through some of the words, let's listen to the story in English. The family pet. John and Sarah had two children. Their son was 5 years old. Their daughter was 7 years old. John and Sarah knew that their children were old enough for some responsibility. They had been asking for a pet for a while. The family was now ready to get one. They didn't know what pet would be best for their lifestyle. A goldfish wouldn't be exciting enough. Sarah was afraid of birds, so they couldn't get a parrot. Okay, now that we've read this page in English, we know some of the words. Let's go ahead and listen to it again.
家庭宠物，约翰和莎拉有两个孩子，儿子五岁了，女儿七岁了。约翰和莎拉知道他们的孩子已经长大了，可以承担起一些责任了。他们一直想要一只宠物，于是准备买一只。他们不知道什么样的宠物最适合他们的生活方式。喂养金鱼的话，体验感不够强。萨拉又怕鸟，所以他们不会养鹦鹉。
All right, hopefully that was a good experience for you to listen to it and maybe recognize a little bit more of the Mandarin the second time through. If you still don't know a lot of it, don't be discouraged. It's just something that comes with time. And as you listen to it, stories repeatedly, you'll pick up more each time. As you study the words, it'll start to make more sense. There's two more pages to this story, so we'll go ahead and listen to those. But first, I want to say that if you want to use this Mandarin reader yourself, you can. Go ahead and sign up. There's a link on the video notes here that will let you sign up for getting a story like this each week in your inbox over email. So go ahead and sign up for that, and then you'll be able to go through the story at your own pace, listen to it as many times as you want, tap on any words to see the meaning of them, and also look at characters, English, pinyin. All right, and with that, let's listen to the last two pages in Mandarin.
他们住在公寓里，养狗没有足够的空间。他们决定养一只猫，但是一只猫会不会有点孤独？豚鼠 或兔子可以养在大笼子里。有人在家时，可以把它们放出来和孩子们一起玩，陪伴家人。夫妻俩向朋友和家人征求意见，来决定选择什么样的宠物。当他们还在寻找合适的宠物时，他们遇到了一位年长的妇人，他正在为他的猫寻找新家。这只猫过去是家里唯一的宠物，这位妇人要搬进一个高级小区，小区不让养猫。约翰和莎拉同意收养这只猫，他们的孩子非常兴奋，迫不及待地想让他们的新宠物搬进来。这只猫喜欢追球，还会花好几个小时看着窗外。把猫咪一带回家，约翰和莎拉就知道他们这个收养的决定是对的。
Thanks for watching.